did you do that for? Now he's seen us.
You want me to put it back on again, Ronnie?
Oh, terrific. Terrific. Now he knows my name and all. Why don't you give him a shoe size while you're at it?
What's the matter? I thought you said we was going to get rid of him.
Yeah, as soon as he's told us what we need to know. You, sit down over there.
Yeah. And shut it. No, you can't have a more comfortable chair. What do you think this is, the frog and gherkin?
Take his clothes off.
What?
I read this article, right? It said nudity demoralizes people. Makes them, you know.
Yeah, naked.
Search him. Don't try anything. Gordon's got a mean streak and I can't control him once he loses it.
Yeah. Right, let's go.
Go away, Spamhead. The cleaners will still be in the bank.
Ouch!
If you make one sound, just one sound.
Oh, do you really think I'd dignify this little charade of yours by yelling? I demand that you let me go this minute. Kidnapping a bank manager is a very serious offence.
Talks posh, Danny.
And don't you think for one moment you can intimidate me?
We'll soon see about that. Bring that toolkit over here, Gordon.
Look, every penny in that bank is my responsibility and I'll guard it with my life. Look, take my wallet. There's at least £200 in there. I don't know you. I don't know your name.
Oh, give it a rest, will you?
That was an Emilio Savani suit. Cost me £800.
You was robbed my ass, knocking him out 150 quid last week.
Look, even with the keys and the combination, you still can't get into the safe.
Who says?
The safe's on a time lock. Can't be open until 9 a.m. on Monday morning.
Oh, don't worry, Mandy. It's only been one night. You know how men lose track of time. Sometimes my father didn't come home for a whole week.
Yeah, sometimes my father didn't come home for a whole month. It's the only time my mother got to sleep on her favorite side of the bed.
Eventually, my father didn't come home at all.
Father Christmas came to our house more often than my real father.
Stop it, stop it. Neither of you are taking this seriously.
Mandy, Michael is big enough to look after himself.
But he's never stayed out all night before.
Oh, look, Mandy, he probably went for a drink with some friends from the bank. Okay, maybe not. You know, I had a dream about you last night.
Leonie. Look, he's probably at home wondering where you are.
You think so?
Michael wasn't in the dream. It was just you. I can't quite remember it now.
No, he's not there. Michael!
No, that'll be Benji.
Oh. Well, I got here as quick as I could. What's all the mystery about? Yeah, there's nothing wrong with pork pie, is there?
No, family crisis. Michael's missing.
Where's the crisis in that? Oh. Morning, Mandy. Pork pie.
Hello, Benji.
Thank heavens you're here.
Well, I don't know if there's anything I can do. I mean, it's not as if Michael and I are exactly tight. I mean, if I was drowning, he'd throw me a brick.
That's it. There was a lot of water in the dream.
Leonie, not now.
Please help me find him. I think something terrible's happened to my foxy Loxy. He could be bleeding in a gutter or lying dead in a mortuary slab.
Captured by aliens who are trying to find out how his unique brain works.
Anyone tried his mobile?
Oh, why didn't I think of that?
Here, I'll go.
Oi, sunshine, wake up. Where do you think you are? Magaluf.
Not again, Mandy. I'm tired.
We didn't bring you here to catch up on your beauty sleep.
Oh, best night's sleep I've had in months.
Mandy been keeping you awake, has she?
How do you know my wife's name?
We've been watching you. We know everything there is to know about you, mate. Everything.
Yeah. When you get up, what you have for breakfast, how many kids you've got.
Kids? Kids! If you...
Hello?
Suppose that was the police.
Why, what's he done wrong?
You thug! You've broken my phone.
You should be glad it wasn't your neck, mate. Go on, search that jacket, see what else he's got in there.
Look, surely it must be obvious by now you're not going to achieve anything by keeping me here. Oh, shut up! Tired, I'm hungry, and I want to go home.
Oh, if I had a pound for every time one of my hostages said that.
August Nepo. Neapo.
Well, give me that.
Augustus Neapolitan Cleveland Grant. That's some name.
Don't you dare open that letter. Interfering with other people's mail is a criminal offence.
Dear Pork Pie. Pork Pie? What kind of stupid name's that?
I like a pork pie, me.
Further to our meeting last week, I have looked into the project we discussed and think that an investment of £2 million...
£2 million?
You know somebody who's got £2 million?
Huh? Technically.
Well, forget about robbing the bank. We'll get this pork pie geezer to pay the ransom to get you back.
Hang on a minute, I know that name. Isn't that the geezer who got all the money off the council because they demolished his block of flats while he was still in it?
Nah, that was some old bird.
No, wait a minute, I've got it. That's the geezer who had the dodgy facelift, and now every time he wants to blow his nose, he has to stick his hand round the back of his head.
No, he's not. He's the man who won £10 million on the lottery.
£10 million?
Yeah. I reckon we should go for the big time, Ronnie. Ask for £20,000.
£20,000? We wouldn't last a week in Acapulco on that. £50,000 will be more like it.
Not very ambitious, are you? How long do you think £50,000 is going to last two men on the run?
Who says we're on the run?
You will be. And besides, I'm worth a lot more than £50,000.
How come?
I'm Pork Pie's financial advisor. He can't run his business without me. He'll pay up.
Do you reckon he'll cough up £100,000?
5 times that at least.
£500,000?
You must be one hell of a banker.
I am.
So tell us again, what exactly happened?
Well, as I said before, there was a lot of water. And Mandy was sitting in our boat.
No. Not the dream, the phone call.
Well, a voice said hello, and then before I had a chance to speak, there was a lot of noise and then silence.
And you're sure it wasn't Michael's voice?
Absolutely.
Even though he only said hello.
Pork Pie, I would know it was Michael if he just breathed down the phone.
Then there's only 3 possibilities, eh? Someone's nicked his mobile, B, you got a cross line, or C. He wasn't on his own.
Are you trying to imply that Michael is up to no good?
Yeah. No. Well, I don't know. I'm just trying to work out what's happened.
Look, I know you think I'm overreacting, but I'm convinced something serious has happened to Michael.
Like what?
I don't know. That's why I'm so worried.
Maybe he's bumped his head and lost his memory.
Yes. You know, that happened to a man I know back in Guyana. His name was Supel Baptiste. He's the richest man in Georgetown. Well, one day the Georgetown Dreamers were playing at a local dance, and Supel was dancing in the front row with a beautiful girl. Then Sweet Sticks, our pan player, he was doing a solo. When one of his sticks flew out of his hand, hit Supel on his head and knocked him out cold. Then he came around, whoop, he lost his memory and never got it back again. He's the peanut seller now.
Nice one, Pork Pie.
Hello? Hello? Is that you, Corvin? Listen, family problems, I can't meet you today. Oh, sorry. You want Mr. Pork Pie? All right. All right. There's no need to talk to me like that. There's a very rude man on the phone wanting to talk to you.
Porkpie speaking. What? You are 500,000 pounds. What for? Now, don't even bother to tell me. Whatever it is, you can keep it.
Porkpie, who was that?
Some damn fool won 500,000 pounds out of me. More stupidness.
No, no, wait, it isn't stupidness, don't you see? The voice on the phone, the silence, Michael never turns off his mobile, and now a demand for money. Somebody has snatched my Foxy Loxy.
You think it could be true?
If it is, they'll live to regret it.
If you hadn't broken my mobile phone, you could have called for...
Shut it! All you've done since you've been here is whinge.
I'm not whinging. I'm complaining. And quite frankly, I've got rather a lot to complain about. I've been kidnapped, kept here against my will, my designer suit is ruined, and now my hands have gone to sleep.
Shame you haven't. Better untie his hands.
Ouch. Now, tell me again, will you?
How many times do you want to hear it?
Look, exactly what did Porkpie say?
Are you sure you two aren't related?
No, I don't think so.
Look, just tell me what he said.
£500,000, you can keep it.
It? What do you mean, it?
Well, you just slammed the phone down.
You did tell him my name, Michael Ambrose.
Oh, well, I didn't exactly get the chance.
What?
I don't think that Porkpie likes you.
Of course he likes me. He's my uncle. Well, practically. He'd do anything for me. Maybe you just asked for too much money.
You told us how much to ask for, and we're not taking a penny less.
We'll just have to show him we mean business.
Yeah, we've messed about long enough. I think it's time we paid your Mandy a little visit. That's the address, Gordon.
Look, don't you dare lay a finger on my wife. And besides, what good would that do? She hasn't got any money.
Yeah, but she could make this Porkpie geezer pay up.
I'll take a few bits and pieces with me. Help her understand the situation.
Gordon, you wouldn't let this animal go near my wife, would you?
Wouldn't know how to stop him, mate.
Pretty, is she, this Mandy? Well, she won't be by the time I'm done with her.
Look, come on, there's no need for that. Look, why don't you just let me write her a note? She'll show it to Porkpie, Uncle Porkpie. He'll be convinced you've got me, and he'll pay up.
You think that'll work?
I'm sure it will.
Do you think I was born yesterday? You'd write it in code.
I wouldn't. You have my word.
Yeah? Well, we'll send her something she'll have no problem understanding.
No, look, I'm sorry, we're not getting anywhere. I'm going to call the police.
And say what?
That Michael has been kidnapped.
All right. If Michael's been kidnapped, where's the ransom note? Rule number one, when you kidnap somebody, you send positive proof that you've got the hostage. Rule number two, you make a list of demands. The ransom note. And rule number three, you make sure the ransom note goes to the person with the money.
So, how comes you know so much about these things?
I don't.
You know a lot more than we do. I didn't even know there was a rule number one.
So what are you trying to say? Just because I know a bit about dodgy dealings, it doesn't make me a villain, does it?
Benji, nobody is saying...
Sure, I've known some villains in my time, but I've told you everything about that part of my life. Well, almost everything. Look, if every time something happens around here, I'm going to get the finger pointed at me, I'd be better off on the streets where you found me.
But no one's accusing you of anything, Benji.
All right, I'll leave if that's what you want. You're happy now.
Thank you, Leonie. Thank you.
Fish, I remember... That's what I dreamt about. Mandy was sitting in a boat when a whole heap of fish swam by. And my mom said, whenever you dream fish, somebody pregnant. And it's not me.
Well, it's not me. Is it?
Hello, Mr. Porkpie's residence. Who's speaking, please? Speak up, I can't hear you. Corvel? It's a terrible line. I think he's Corvel. Is that you, Corvel? What you say? That's no way to talk to a lady. No, I'm not Mrs. Porkpie. No, I'm not Michael's wife either. What?
Hello? 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 There's nobody there. They've hung up.
I think he ran out of money.
When is it going to be my turn?
When you get out of jail. Tell you what, for 500 quid, you can have my get out of jail card.
But that's extortion. It should only be £200.
Suit yourself.
Okay, look, I'll give you the Old Kent Road.
Nothing doing.
I'm not finished. Plus Pentonville. That should appeal to you.
There's only going to be one winner around here, mate. That's me. What took you so long?
His missus. She weren't in.
Thank God.
I went all that way for nothing. So I rang that Paul Pye's number, and all I get is some smart Alec Bird keeps calling me Corvette.
Corvell. That's Leonie's boyfriend. He's from St. Lucia, one of the French speaking islands.
Turn it in, will you? Then what happened?
Well, I ran out of change before I could.
You don't believe it. Get back to that phone and try to get it right this time.
No point phoning Pork Pie now. He'll be at the centre.
Well, give us a number then.
Certainly not.
What's this game?
Shut up.
Look, I'm just trying to help.
Well, give us a number for the centre then.
There's no point. If you don't go there in person, how are you going to get the money out of the safe?
You mean to tell me there's a safe full of money in the centre?
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Well, I'll just go down there and get...
Oh. Maybe I should go, Gordon.
What do you know about cracking safes?
Nothing. Same as you. I'll just get this Pork Pie geezer to open it up.
And I'll never see you or the money again. I am not happy.
You've got to learn to trust people, Gordon. All right, we'll both go then.
What about him?
Yeah. Well, I'll make sure he's still here when we get back. Take your trousers off.
I beg your pardon.
You want me to take them off for you?
You know, this tension is playing havoc with my digestion.
I'm not feeling too good myself.
They say the first 3 months are the worst.
No, Leonie, that's not why I'm feeling queasy. I'm just worried about Michael.
I can't believe they haven't phoned again to tell us what to do.
It's all part of their plan. They'd burst in here with tear gas and machine guns and hold us all hostage until Mr. Porkpie hands over all his money.
You've been watching too much telly.
I just want Michael here safely and in one piece.
I should have taken it more seriously from the beginning. Even from his grave, Desmond would never forgive me if anything happened to his big son. I would never forgive myself either. You know, I held that boy in my arms when he was a baby.
Which would you prefer, a boy or a girl?
Girl? Boy? No, Leonie, I'm not pregnant.
All right. Well, why don't you put it to the test then?
Hello? Yes, Mandy, Michael's wife. Is he all right? Yes, I understand. I've got that. They want us to go to the centre and await further instructions. Oh, Michael!
Look, Ronnie, Maria.
Brilliant, Spamhead. But where is here?
There. I know. We can ask a policeman.
Strange not having any customers in here. You know, I think I prefer it.
Well, we could have hardly have opened up under the circumstances.
Look, I'm waiting no longer. I am calling the police.
No, wait. You can't do that, because if you do, my baby won't have a father.
What?
You mean you're...
Pregnant, yes. Fish, you see? I'm glad I made you buy that pregnancy kit on the way here.
You were right.
My dreams are never wrong.
Pity you didn't dream about Michael. Now what are we
going
to do?
Oh, I'm going to call the police.
No, wait. Don't do that. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I call them.
Hello?
hunger.
Left at the traffic lights.
Well, they say missing persons are not a priority until someone has been missing for more than 24 hours. But as they know me, they're sending a couple of officers over anyway.
Thank you, Porkpie.
You want a cushion? Some water? Corned beef and condensed milk sandwich. And my wife Gwendolyn was pregnant?
I'm fine.
You sure?
You're him, ain't ya?
Him who?
We've got something for you.
What's this?
This is Michael's suit.
Yeah. If you want to see him again, you better show us where the safe is.
Safe? What safe?
I knew we couldn't trust that Michael. He set us up.
Listen, you just tell us where he is, and we might even let you walk out of here before the law gets here.
Did you not tell her no police?
Well, of course I did. Michael!
Michael, they're pregnant. You're going to be a daddy.
What's he doing here?
Never mind that. Let's get out of here.
Mr. Grant, about a...
Kidnapping? Now then, mate, just stay right where you are.
You don't understand, officer.
It's all right, sir. Just stand back.
No, you've got this all wrong. It's those two you want.
Ronnie and Gordon.
Playing games again, are we?
You're nicked.
Oh, look, look. Okay. Oh, darling, this is the happiest day of my life.
Oh, why, quite an eventful day, eh? What with kidnappings and pregnancies?
Hey, congratulations! Benji, open the bar. Let's celebrate.
Champagne?
But of course. But orange juice for you, Mandy.
Yaman! Yeah,